Nationalist MP of Samagi Janabalavege, Tayana Gamage, too was in favour of it. Parliamentarian of the Sri Lanka Podujana Peramuna, Dr. Vijayadasa Rajapaksha, who was a strong critic of the 20th Amendment, also voted in favour. Later, commencing the third reading of the 20A Bill, also known as the committee stage, Minister of Justice President's Council Ali Sabri added 57 articles to the Amendment Bill. Thereafter, Chief Opposition Whip Lakshman Kiriella called for a vote on the dual citizenship article included in the bill. A vote was duly taken with 157 voting for and 64 voting against the article. Digamadula District MP S.M.M. Musharraf, representing Muslim National Alliance led by Rishad Badiuddin, who voted against 20A during the second reading vote, voted in favour of enabling dual citizens to represent the parliament. The 20th Amendment to the Constitution was passed in Parliament by a two-thirds majority and it will become the law of the country once signed by the Speaker. Meanwhile, following yesterday's parliamentary session, an opposition MP who voted in favour of the 20th Amendment expressed views to media.
විපක්ෂයන් කරන චෝදනාවක් තමයි ඔබතුමා මේ සල්ලි වලට තමයි මේ තීන්දුව ගත්තේ කියලා.
පිස්සු අපිට සල්ලි තෝන්නේ, පොෂන් තෝන්නේ. අපි තීරණය ගත්තේ මේ රට හැදියට මේ ඉදිරියට ගෙනියන්න ජනාධිපතිතුමා පිළිගන්න. ඒකට යන්න පුළුවන් වෙයි කියලා පිළිගන්නවා. ඒ නිසා අපි දැන් දෙන්නා.
SJP MP Diana Gamage meanwhile explained her reasons behind the decision to support the 20th Amendment on her way out of the Parliament today.
ඒක මම මගේ හිතට එකක වරද සාක්ෂියට අනුව ගත්ත තීරණයක්. අපිට ඕන බලයක් තියෙන ජනාධිපති කෙනෙක් රටක. අඩුම ගානේ තමන් යටතට මේ ආරක්ෂක අමාත්‍යාංශය කියන දේවත් ගන්න බැරි ජනාධිපති කෙනෙක් මොකටද අපිට මේ රටේ? මේ රටේ මිනිස්සු මේ විශ්වාසයක් දීලා සිස්ටම් චේන්ජ් කරන්න කියලා දැන් ගෝඨාභය මහත්තයට ඡන්දෙ දුන්නනේ. ඒ මිනිස්සුන්ගේ බලාපොරොත්තු වලට මොකද එතකොට දැන් වෙන්නේ? එතකොට මේ රටේ ජනාධිපති අපේ ජනාධිපති නෙමෙයිද?
දැන් ඔබතුමියට විරුද්ධව විනය ක්‍රියාමාර්ග ගන්න හදන්නේ පක්ෂින්.
මොකද්ද විනය පරීක්ෂණ කරපු දෙන් එතනට එතනට ආවහම අපි ඒකට මුණ දෙමු. දැන් මේකේ හැමදාම ගෝඨාභය රාජපක්ෂ මේක බදාගෙන සදාකල් තියන් ඉන්න දෙයන්නේ නෑනේ. තව කෙනෙක් හෙට අනිද්ද තව අවුරුදු පහකින් ජනාධිපති වෙන්න පුළුවන්නේ. ඒ සජිත් ප්‍රේමදාස මැතිතුමා වෙන්න පුළුවන්නේ. එතුමා එතකොට ඇවිල්ලා කියනවද නෑ මට එපා මේ බලය. එතකොට එතුමා මේ ජනතාවට දෙන පොරොන්දු ඉටු කරන්නේ කොහොමද? මේකට මම එකඟයි මේ රට ඉදිරියට යන්න ඕන.
දැන් සජිත් ප්‍රේමදාස මහතා කතා කළ මොකද ඇහුවේ? ඡන්දෙ දුන්නයි පස්සේ ඔබතුමියගෙන.
එතුමාගේ කිසි මේ මොකද එතුමාට මම දන්නල ගියේ.
එතුමා එපා කිව්වේ නැද්ද?
එතුමා එපා කිව්වා.
එතුමා ඔබතුමිය වගකීමෙන්ද කියන ඔබතුමිය මුදලට විකුණුන්නේ නැහැ.
මට සල්ලි ඕනේ නැහැ. මොකටද මට සල්ලි? මට සල්ලි දෙන්න.
With the introduction of the new amendment, several constitutional changes are to take place. From now on, under the observation of Parliament, the President is vested with the power to appoint the Chief Justice, Justices of the Supreme Court, the President of the Court of Appeal and its judges, the Attorney General, the Inspector General of Police, the Auditor General and the Ombudsman. The article which says the President shall, on the advice of the Prime Minister, appoint from among members of Parliament ministers to be in charge of the ministries will be repealed in the 20th Amendment and the President will have the power to appoint the Prime Minister and ministers at his discretion. Also, the President possesses the power to have a ministerial post under his purview. The number of members of the three-member election commission has been revised to 5 and the president is given the power via the constitution to appoint members of the commission as well as its chairman. The president has been empowered by the new amendment to dissolve parliament after 2.5 years of its sitting, amending the previous article which stated that the parliament cannot be dissolved until 4.5 years of its sitting. The Constitutional Council will henceforth be abolished. Its right to appoint members to independent commissions too will be abolished and instead, the Parliamentary Council has been introduced by the 20th Amendment. Being a dual citizen will no longer serve as a disqualification to run for the presidency or a parliamentary election as the barrier was removed by the newly passed amendment. The power to appoint heads of departments is now vested in the Cabinet by the 20th Amendment. Meanwhile, by the 20th Amendment, the number of Supreme Court judges has been increased from 11 to 17 and the number of justices of the Court of Appeal has also been increased from 12 to 20 while appointing the President as the authority to make such appointments. The 20th Amendment, however, will keep the term of office of the President at a maximum of 5 years and a maximum of 2 terms. It will also retain the number of cabinet ministers at 30 and the maximum number of deputy ministers at 40. Apart from these, the 20th Amendment does not include any proposals that require a public referendum for passing.
We will see you shortly. Bear with us.
Liver Ayush, Karabuneti Dantale Paya, Shakti Mat Dattipalakat.